cut from my side. So guys, is it clear? Work from home, work from office, the difference between work from home and office, what is VPN software? Sometimes they will ask in the interview, okay, which VPN software you will use. If you don't know what is VPN, then it is a difficult thing. Okay. They won't ask you next question also. That's it. That is the last question, and we'll call you, or HR will get back to you. She won't get back to us. Okay. She will get back to other person. Okay. Fine. So this is how it will work, guys. So you should have some knowledge on the VPN softwares and all. So you can tell anything. If anyone asks you which VPN software you will use, you can tell PulseSecure or Global Protect. Okay, a lot of VPN softwares are there. If you have some time, just browse it, any VPN softwares in the market, so that you can tell any VPN software. Okay, right. So this is how the setup will be there. If you are doing work from office, no need to connect to any VPN, as you're already connected to the office network. You can directly open RDP, and then you can either directly connect to the Windows server or whatever servers you have access, or else you can connect to Jump server first, then from Jump server you can connect to your server. Please mute it if you don't have questions. Okay, if you are doing work from home,
sir.
Yes, tell
is
me.
Is there any special process to connect with the Citrix Jump software, sir?
There is no special process, sir. You can see a standard document once you go to the office. Using that standard documents, first you have to configure Citrix apps in your desktop. Sometimes Windows people only will help you to configure the Citrix apps. You have to open, you have to follow on-screen instructions. Okay, it's not a rocket science. You can simply understand. Nothing will be there in that. Okay, simply you'll have some VDI interfaces and all. Which VDI interface you want to connect, you can select that VDI interface and then you can connect to that. I cannot show you, okay? We don't have that Citrix apps and all. Okay? Fine. Guys, any issues, any doubts here? Is it clear, everyone? Guys, okay, please don't hesitate to ask questions. It's not an issue. You are learning the course. You are not learning for others. You are learning for your career. Okay, not for others' career and all. Okay, so if you have any questions, immediately you can stop and you can ask me. Nothing like that. Okay, so don't hesitate. Everyone is new. That's why they are paying money and they are learning the course. Okay, so don't think like if I ask this question, someone will think different. No, you will also learn from you, from your questions and all. Don't hesitate to ask the questions. We have a lot of servers available, right? So each server, we need to enter login for each server, or else we have to access all. Depends, Sashi. But the default behavior is, if you want to access 100 servers, you are not going to work at a time, right? Our 1,000 servers are there in my office. I'm not going to work on 1,000 servers at a time, right? Anyhow, you have to work one by one only, right? At a time, how much work you can do on how many servers you can do parallelly. Okay, one server, two servers, hardly three servers. Okay, you can connect multiple servers at a time, but usually one by one is better. Okay, so like simply connecting 100 servers is not possible. Might be you are doing patching. Parallelly, you can connect to 3 or 4 servers or 5 servers or 10 servers. But it depends. You are going to do work one by one only, right? So all servers we won't connect. Any issue is there, then only we'll connect to the server. Yes, client server. Clear, Shashi? Is it clear? Right, guys, any questions, any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. Right, so Girija, Anis, is it clear?
No, sir. Okay, sir.
Yeah, okay, fine. Right, okay, let me go to this chat. Okay, fine. Right. So what we are going to do now, we have already created the server, right? So we'll enable the remote connections. Okay. As of now, we haven't enabled the remote connections. So we cannot connect to the server remotely. Our server name is batch 40, right? So we'll connect to the server remotely. I'll show you how to connect to the server remotely. So before that, first of all, we have to enable some settings. Okay. To connect to the server remotely. And again, this is done by your Windows team and network team. You won't do this activity in the organization. It's a simple activity only, but you don't have permission to do. simply your Windows team and your network team will enable remote connections. Once they enable the remote connections, then only you can connect to the server remotely, right? So yesterday we have configured, we just installed Windows Server, right? So you can see like this. Once you started your Windows Server, you will get this screen, guys. This is the server, okay? You can see right up to here. Okay, this is your server, complete server. So first of all, I want to log into the server. Okay, how can I log into the server? I want to check what is the IP address of the server. Why? Because I should know, okay, IP address to connect to the server, right? I don't know what is the IP address of this machine. Okay, so I want to connect to the server.
Sir, first go to CMD and then IP config, sir.
Yes, okay, so, okay. So I can get the IP information using a command. Okay, I have to run one command in this server, then I'll get the IP address. Okay, so what I'm going to do, let me log into this server first. Okay, how can I log in? Just click on this black interface just once and use your control plus delete, not control alt delete. Use your only control button plus delete button. Again, okay, again, you guys will do the same mistake. Use only control plus delete button to get the login screen. Control, we have two controls on your keyboard. One is there on the left side, one is there on the right side. Okay, so what you have to do, right control plus delete. Which one, which is near to your arrow keys. Okay, one control button will be there. Just hit right control plus delete. Or if it's difficult for you, go to input and you can see keyboard and you can use this also. Insert control alt delete button. This also you can click, you will get the window login screen. Okay, I'm using shortcut right control plus delete. Okay, yesterday after installation, we gave one password for administrator, right? That password you have to give now, okay, to log into this Windows server. Okay, so now I am able to log into the Windows server. Now, first, what I have to do, I have to first enable the remote settings for this machine. There are two settings that you have to change to enable the remote connections. So one is from your Oracle VirtualBox Manager. Go to your Oracle VirtualBox Manager, go to the network settings, right click settings of this machine, go to your network settings. There you can see attached to NAT is there, right? Select a bridged adapter and make sure Intel dual band wireless adapter is selected. No need to select anything. Go to advanced, select allow all. Okay, this is one thing you have to do, one setting. This is one setting you have to do. What is the second setting? Go to the machine. Okay, once you enable that one, usually you will get network interface here like this. Yes or no pop-up will come. Just click on yes. Don't click no. Okay, just click on yes. Once you completed this, go to your this PC properties. Okay, this PC is there, right? Right click properties. Go to remote settings. Okay, select this option, allow remote connections to this computer. Again click okay. Sometimes if you select this option, you can see, right, allow connections only from computers running remote desktop. Okay, sometimes if you select this option, you may get error. Sometimes if you don't select this option, you may not get error. Okay, let it be as it is. We'll see if we get the error, how to troubleshoot, I'll show you. Okay, just click apply and okay. Fine. So these are the two settings you have to do, okay, to connect to the server remotely. Right, you can close this window. Whenever you connect it to the server, automatically one window will open, that is called server manager. It will automatically open, nothing to do anything here. Simply minimize this server manager or you can close the server manager. Okay, right. So now remote settings are enabled. So first I want to connect to the server remotely, right? So I want to give the server IP address, right? So I will check the IP address. So to check the IP address of the server, what you have to do? Open run here, just type Windows button, open run. Okay, you will get this interface. Okay, just simply type your command prompt CMD to open command prompt, just type CMD. And then now if you want to find IP address of any machine, you have to type ipconfig. The command is ipconfig, configuration. Config means configuration. Don't give any spaces, guys. Ipconfig, you have to type it and you can hit enter. You will get the IP address. See here, what is the IP address? You have to consider IPv4 only. not IPv6 and all. Okay, and not your subnet mask, not your default gateway. Only you have to consider IPv4, that is 192.168.0.104. As we are connected through internet, you will get 192 series, okay, in your laptop. But in the organizations, the server IP address usually will be in the range of 10 series. 10.10.10.25, 10.10.10.122, 10.2.1.22. So like this, the organization servers will be in 10 series range. IP address for your organizations or organization servers are in 10 series. Okay, 10.10.10.1, something like that. This is just an example. Something like that, your server IP address will be like that. Okay, so now you can see the IP address, right? 192.168.0.104. I have to use this IP address to connect to the server remotely. Go to your local laptop. Again, guys, where I am doing what kind of activity, you have to be very careful. Okay, I just opened run in the Windows server, not in my local laptop. What you will do sometimes, simply you will open run in your local laptop. Okay, and what you will do, you will simply, okay, check IP config. Okay, I'm sorry. What is this? CMD. Okay. You will open run in your local laptop and you will type IP config and you will get lot of IP addresses and you don't know which IP address you have to use and all. Okay. So guys, don't use your local run. Okay. Use your server. Why? Because you have to find the server IP address, right? Okay. Now you are going to, again, here, make sure, okay, where you are opening RDP console, in your laptop only, right? In your laptop, for our setup, okay, we have set up like this. Okay, let me go to Windows server again. Windows server. Let me go to this one. Okay, what we are doing, guys, we have installed Windows server in our local laptop itself. Okay, we have installed Windows server. Usually in the organization, Windows servers will be there outside your laptop. But for practice, we have installed Windows server in our laptop only. So you have to open RDP in the laptop, not in the Windows server. Guys, is it clear? You are connecting remotely from your local laptop to the server. So where you have to open RDP? In your local laptop, you have to open RDP. Clear, guys? Any issue, any doubts, any confusion is there? Is it clear, everyone?
No, sir.
Clear, right? So you have to open RDP in your laptop, not in the server, guys. People will always open RDP in the server and they will connect to the server remotely from that server itself. How it is possible, tell me. You have to open RDP in your laptop and then you have to type IP address of this server and then you can connect to the server remotely. That's what we are doing now. I'm not going to confuse you. Just giving some clarity how it is working. Now everyone is clear, right? Everyone, we are good.
Yes.
Okay, fine. Yes, so now let me open RDP in my local laptop. RDP, okay? You can get this one. Just click on this remote desktop and it is asking to which server you want me to connect. What is my server IP address, guys? 104, 192.168.104. Okay, so go to this 192.168.0.104. Give the IP address 104. Click on connect button. Okay. If everything is fine, it will ask you to give the administrator password. Yesterday, after installation, we set up one password for administrator user, right? That password you have to give here. Okay. So I'm giving the password, guys. Let me give the password 123. Right. So now you can see you are getting one error. This could be due to CRED SSP encryption error. We can fix this error. Okay. Remember this one. Just click OK. Go to your server. Okay. Go to your server. Again, go to the remote settings. This PC, right click, properties, remote settings. Uncheck this one. Uncheck, apply, OK. If you got sometimes, why I don't want to confuse you. Sometimes if the option is selected, you will get the remote connection. Sometimes if it is unselected, you will get the remote connection. That's why to fix the error by your own, I am just okay showing how to fix it and all. Okay, right. Now again, let me go to this window. Again, provide the IP address to which server you want to connect. Click on connect button. and just give the password of the machine server, not your laptop. Okay. Now see guys, now you will get like this. Yes or no? What I have to click now? Yes or no? Sir. Tell me guys.
Yes, yes.
Everyone.
Yes.
Just try it. Yes or no? I have to click. Okay, so I have to click yes. Okay, not no. If you click no, it will be closed. Your RDP session will be closed. Okay, so guys, this is how we'll connect to the server remotely. Okay, now you can see, right, this blue bar, you can drag it. Okay, you can drag this blue bar and you can maximize, you can minimize, whatever you want, you can do. Okay, so you can just click on it and you can drag it. Okay, like this. And this is the minimize button. Completely the server is going to be minimized, and you can see again you can maximize, and this is like a, it is going to, like what you can see, it is going to reset the view. Okay, you can see again some small window you will get, and if you want to get full view, double click on this, again you will get the complete view. Clear, everyone? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Right, 1 minute guys, let me close this one. Yes, okay, now this is how the server look like. This is how, this is your taskbar. Okay, you can see the date and time, and you can see, okay, your windows and all. You can close it now, we don't need this one, and you can close this. Once you connected to the server remotely, guys, direct connection will be locked. Either you can connect to the server directly, this is your direct connection. If you just again trying to connect to the server directly, your remote connection will be closed. If you connect to the server remotely, your direct connection will be closed. Clear, everyone? Either you can go for direct connection or remote connection. By remote connections, we'll usually connect to the server remotely in the organization. That's why we use it to use this remote connections regularly. Okay. So very important, guys, very, very important. You may be proficient in the SQL DBA, but you don't know how to connect to the server remotely. That's it. First day itself, your job will be gone. Yes, there are some students, okay? They don't know, they are good in the subject, but they don't know how to connect to the server. No trainer is showing how to connect to the server remotely, guys. Believe me. Simply, they will start with the SQL Server installation and then they will proceed. It's very important, right? This is very small, but very important thing. Okay, so this is how we'll connect to the server remotely in the organization. This is direct remote settings. If you are using any softwares like what is that, Citrix apps and all, it's not a big deal. From there also we'll connect like this only. Extra thing is, you first you have to connect to the Citrix apps. Then from Citrix apps, you are going to connect to the server remotely by using this MSTSC. Clear, everyone? Any issues, any doubts?
No, sir.
No.
Fine, okay. So, right now, this is our remote desktop connection. If you have any doubts, let me know. Okay, fine. So, server is ready. Okay, now server is ready. Now, what we can do is, we can install the SQL Server. Now Windows Server is completely ready. Now we can install the SQL Server. So let's go for some prerequisite, basic prerequisites for installing your SQL Server. Okay, right. So now I want to install SQL Server 2017, guys. Okay, remember, I want to install SQL Server 2017. Now in this machine, I want to install SQL Server 2017. Okay, I want to install SQL Server 2017. Right. So there are some prerequisites are there to install the software, hardware requirements, please mute it, and software requirements. Okay, so we have hardware requirements and we have software requirements. If you want to install SQL Server, not only SQL Server 2017, if you want to install any SQL Server version, okay, we have some hardware requirements and software requirements. We have to follow these requirements, okay, and make sure these requirements are already set up. Hardware requirements, you know, right? RAM, okay, storage, CPU, these are the main hardware requirements. Okay, so there are some minimum values are there, 2 GB RAM, okay, 4 GB storage, one CPU. Okay, so no need to remember this minimum hardware requirements, guys. Why? Because in the organization, we don't configure servers with minimum hardware requirements and all. Okay, we'll have 16 GB or 8 GB, at least worst case 8 GB, 8 GB RAM machines are there, 16 GB machines RAM, 16 GB RAM servers will be there, 32 GB, 64 GB, 128 GB servers will be there. So there is no need to remember the minimum hardware requirements. Okay, fine. Software requirements. What are the software requirements we have to concentrate? Guys, tell me what is the main software requirement if you want to install SQL Server. Can anyone tell me?
Oracle.
.NET, sir.
Very good. Very good. .NET framework. We should have .NET framework. See, Oracle and all should be there. I'll accept Oracle, Hyper-V, or else your VMware should be there. We just crossed that stage now. Everything is ready. Server is ready. Okay, now what we have to do, what kind of other extra add-ons we have to install before installing SQL Server. So the minimum basic requirement is .NET framework should be installed. Yes, Anis, okay, OS should be there. Of course, we have already installed OS also. Okay, right. So now after installation of OS, once the machine is ready, we should have .NET framework, guys. .NET framework, okay, to install your SQL Server. So your SQL Server mainly runs on .NET framework, okay, language and all. So it's very important we should have .NET framework. Then only we can install, okay, SQL Server. If we don't have .NET framework, we cannot install. Of course, yes, Windows operating system should be there. Oracle VirtualBox should be there to configure the Windows operating system. Apart from these things, of course, you should have SQL Server software also, right? Without SQL Server software, can we install? So SQL Server software also should be there. But apart from this, the main important thing is .NET framework should be installed in the machine. Then only you can proceed for SQL Server installation. Okay. So I'll show you how to install .NET framework in today's class. Okay. We'll close early. Then tomorrow, freshly, we'll start SQL Server installation. Okay. Fine. Right. Let me install .NET framework on the server. This is my server, right? Let me go to the server. 1 minute. Okay. Every time. Yeah. So this is my server. Okay. You can see these are the icons and all. So if you want to install anything on this server, remember, if you want to install anything on the server, we'll use server manager, guys. If you want to install anything on the server, we will use the server manager. Okay. So we'll use server manager, and from where we can open the server manager, it will be there on the taskbar itself. This is your taskbar, guys. Okay. This is your taskbar. This is called taskbar. Okay. This is your Windows bar. Okay. You can just click on Windows button. You will get a lot of options. Go to the taskbar. Just click on the server box. You can see right on server with box. This is your server manager. If you want to install any softwares, we usually use server manager only to install the softwares. Select this add roles and features. Please minimize, sir. Which one I have to minimize, Srinivas?
Sir, your screen not visible to me, sir. Please minimize that. That is expanded. Bottom side icons we are unable to watch.
I'm not sure. Everyone, guys, everyone is having same issue.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Not able to see bottom, sir. Taskbar, sir.
Not able to see, okay. Now can you see? Let me 1 minute, guys. Okay. You cannot see this one, the bottom taskbar, you cannot see.
Yes, sir.
Sorry?
Yes, sir. Bottom side icons we are unable to watch.
Okay. Okay, let me do one thing. Okay, let me minimize this one. And where is my server?
Mobile was okay for me, sir. So,
just 1 minute, guys. I don't know. I never listened this complaint from anyone. You are watching from mobile or phone? This one? Laptop?
Laptop, sir. Laptop, sir.
Okay. Let me do one thing. Let me hide this meeting controls first. and let me go down. Now can you see? Or else let me do one thing, okay? No problem.
Okay. Actually, అది ఏమవుతుందంటే సార్ మా జూమ్ కింద మళ్ళీ మాకు మీటూ స్టార్ వీడియో ఇవన్నీ ఉంటాయి కదా సార్
ఓకే డు వన్ థింగ్ డు వన్ థింగ్ హైడ్ చేస్తాను సార్ డు వన్ థింగ్ ఓకే జస్ట్ యు విల్ హావ్ ఎన్ ఆప్షన్ ఆన్ ద టాప్ హైడ్ మీటింగ్ కంట్రోల్స్ ఓకే సెలెక్ట్ దట్ హైడ్ మీటింగ్ కంట్రోల్స్ ఆర్ కంట్రోల్ షిఫ్ట్ ఆల్ట్ హెచ్ బటన్ ఇస్ ద షార్ట్ కట్ కంట్రోల్ షిఫ్ట్ ఆల్ట్ హెచ్ ఇస్ ద షార్ట్ కట్ అండ్ ద కంట్రోల్స్ విల్ బి హైడ్ హిడెన్ ఓకే The Zoom meeting controls will be in hidden mode.
Use sir, repeat, sir.
Control Shift Alt. Control Shift Alt plus H button. Hide. H means hide. Or you can see the three dots in the Zoom. You can choose hide meeting controls. Okay. Or else not an issue. Let me. What I can do is let me do one thing. Even for me also sometimes it is creating some disturbance. I want to take snip. Anyone like anyone is able to close the meeting controls using control alt shift h button? Okay, that's fine. I'll show you, no problem. Okay, later I'll show you. Nothing, simply once you open you will get the taskbar. Of course you know right what is taskbar,
sir. Okay. It is better to use control settings and always
Yeah, that's okay, guys. That's okay. It's not an issue. Once you log into the server, you can see there are only three icons on the server. Okay, you can easily see what is the server manager. Place your cursor there. It will show you what is the server manager. Okay. Once you open, now you will get this window. Okay. Once you open, you will get this server manager window like this. It will be okay. You will get the server manager window. Now you can see server manager window, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So just click on add roles and features. If you want to install any software on the server, you have to use the server manager only. Through server manager only we'll install most of the softwares. Okay, right. Next, and who will install .NET framework, guys, in the organization? Windows team or SQL team?
Sir, Windows team, sir.
Not network team. Okay.
Windows, not SQL team, sir.
SQL team only, na?
Yes, yes.
Not SQL team only, it's the responsibility of Windows team. After installation of Windows operating system, it's mandatory, okay? It's mandatory to install. .NET framework is not only mandatory for SQL server, it's mandatory for a lot of applications. So Windows team, after installation of Windows server, they will install, okay, .NET framework. Okay, so it's the responsibility of the Windows team, okay? They will install .NET framework. Right. Let me go to next. So we can go to next and install. Not an issue. Installing .NET framework is not a big thing. Let me go to next. Okay. Again, go to next. And again, go to next. You can see features. You can see right .NET framework 3.5. .NET framework 4.5 is already selected. We usually use .NET framework 2.0, 3.0, 3.5, 4.5. 4.5 is already selected, not installed. Okay, selected, and you have to choose this .NET framework 3.5. And if you want to expand, you can select, you can expand, and you can choose all the components in the .NET framework 3.5. That's it. Okay, you can minimize it, and you can go to next, 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 and here you have to do one setting. Okay, here you have to do one setting. Okay. So you have to provide the software from which software you want to install this .NET framework. Actually, these softwares will be there in your Windows operating system file. Okay, the softwares will be there in your Windows operating system file. Just check whether your operating system is attached or not in the D drive. Open my computer or this PC. You can see, right? You can see in the D drive, Windows operating system is already attached. In this Windows operating system, you have your .NET framework software. Okay, So what we have to do here, simply select this option, specify an alternate source path, select this option. Here you have to provide the path in which path your .NET framework is there. You can see here, right, E colon sources, yes, X, yes, right. On behalf of E, your software is there in the D drive, right? Give D colon sources, same as it is. Just on behalf of E, you have to provide D. Why? Because your Windows Server software is there in the D drive.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Clear, guys, everyone? Nothing. I am just providing the path. In which path your software is there, I am just providing the path. And make sure, okay, Windows operating system is already attached. If not, you know, right, how to attach. Go to your Oracle VirtualBox Manager. Go to the settings of this machine. Go to the storage settings yesterday. Just here you can see one empty CD. Select that empty CD. And once you downloaded the software, you can attach the Windows Server 2012 software. That is how you have to attach it. Okay, then it will be attached as a D drive in your operating, in your server. It will be attached as a D drive. Then your path is there in the D drive, right? Your .NET framework path is there in the D drive. So you have to use this D drive. Okay, D colon sources X, S, X, yes, X, yes. Okay, so you have to provide this path. So remember, guys, don't do mistake here. Once you, in case if any mistake is there, .NET framework won't be installed. Okay, just click OK now and click on install button. Okay, so this is how we usually install. So you can see the status here. Okay, how much completed you can see here. .NET framework 3.5 includes .NET framework 2.0, 3.0 and .NET framework 4.5 also. Installation is started. You can see once installation is completed, you can see the status as installation is succeeded. Okay, just wait for 2 minutes. It will install. Once .NET framework is installed, okay, you have to restart your Windows Server. Then you can proceed for installing SQL Server. Tomorrow we'll discuss those things. Okay, just wait for 2 minutes. Once installation is completed, then we'll discuss if any doubts are there.
Sir, in organization, how many teams will be there, and can you please explain their roles, sir?
See, in the organization, lot of teams will be involved. Okay. Just a minute, okay. I'll tell you just a minute. Dharmavaram, that in and Dharmavaram. Right, okay. So in the organization, you will have a lot of teams. Okay, so what are the teams involved usually? We usually have, okay, Windows team and VM team. Both will be done by the Windows team only, creating virtual machines and all. We will have network team, okay? We will have storage team. In some organization, you will have backup team, okay? Backup team and all. And of course, we'll have SQL DBA team, database DBA team. In the DBA, you will have again SQL DBA, Oracle DBA, DBA teams, okay? SQL DBA, Oracle DBA, MySQL, NoSQL, what are the, like Postgres, MongoDB, like different teams. Those are different from project to project, okay? So these are very common groups, Windows team plus VM. Sometimes Windows team is different, VM team is different. From Windows only, they will, okay, again, differentiate again. Two teams, Windows team, VM team and all, okay? VOps, you can call it as, let me tell you the terminology. Windows team, you can call it as WinOps, okay? Windows operations, WinOps team. Okay. VM team, you can call it as VOps, virtual machine operations team. Okay. Or you can call this team as Wintel team also. You can call this as sometimes some organization they will call WinOps team, some organization they will call as Wintel team. Okay. And VOps, virtual operations and all, they are going to take care of creating virtual machines and all, they will take care of it. Network team, NetOps, network operations. There is no storage ops. Okay. Usually you can call it as a storage team only. Okay. Backup team. Okay. They are going to take care of all the backups, not only SQL Server backups. It's not like it's mandatory. Okay. Sometimes you may have, sometimes you may not have. It depends upon the company to company. But these teams are mandatory. Windows team will be there, WinOps team, VOps team, network team. Okay. And DBA teams. In DBA also, you will have a lot of teams. Okay. Again, depends upon the technology, different teams will be there. Windows activities will be taken care by the Windows team. Virtual machines activities will be taken care by the VOps team. Network related assigning IPs, reserving IP addresses and all, opening ports and all will be taken care by the network team. Adding storage, removing the storage, fixing the storage related issues will be taken care by the storage team. Of course, a backup team will take care of the backups. In case if any third party tools are there, they'll use third party tools to take the backups for all the softwares, Oracle software, SQL DBA, MySQL, NoSQL. Okay, finally, your DBA teams will take care of the databases. These are the common teams involved in the operations. Okay, so if you see here, installation is succeeded on this machine. Okay, this is server name. And that's it. You can see here, once you can see this success message, you can close this window and you can restart the server. Okay. So that you can install SQL Server. So that will be discussed in the next class tomorrow. We'll connect at 7 a.m. Guys, and as discussed, okay. So 1 minute, just a minute. Just 1 minute. Let me open Control Shift Alt H. Okay. And cluster-based installation of SQL Server means, Suni, I'll explain. There are two types of installations. As of now, we haven't started SQL Server installation, right? I'll tell you while installing SQL Servers, what is this cluster-based installation, okay? Anis, what about developers? Developers, of course. Anis, yes, sorry for the time. Okay, developers team also will be there, DBS and developers. Developers will take care of the development activities and all, writing logics, writing coding and all. Developers team, testing team, okay, so HR team, transportation department, okay, right? So those are the different things. Of course, we have to consider developers team, but usually, okay, we'll consider operations side, we'll consider these teams, whatever we discussed, okay. Fine, as a DB, we need to back the data. I'll tell you, Shashi, why again backup team required. I'll tell you why backup team is required and all, why we'll discuss, okay? So guys, that's it for today. The meeting is going to end now. And again, please ping me as